Hello everyone and welcome to this session on JMeter beginner tutorial. This is the third session of this series, and in the earlier two sessions we saw how do we install and set up JMeter on Windows as well as on a Mac machine, and we also discussed that because JMeter is a Java application and therefore it is independent of the platform and the operating system, so it does not matter whether you are using JMeter on a Windows machine or on a Mac machine, it will work exactly in the same way on both the operating systems. The only difference that we saw was the way we start JMeter on a Windows and a Mac. Okay, so in case you have not seen the earlier sessions, I would request you to go back and see those sessions because they are very basic and they are very, you know, stepwise session to install and, you know, start using JMeter. In the second series we also saw how do we create a very simple test plan and how do we create a performance test for a web application or a web page. Okay, now this is the third session, and this is for assertions. And assertion in very simple words is a check on the response. Okay, so when we send our request to the server, we get back some response, and if you want to do some checks on the response, whether the response code we want to check, whether we have received a 200 response code, or we want to check some text in the response, we may also want to test the format of the response, or we may want to test the duration of the response, the time it took to send back the response, or we may also want to check the size of the response, right? So there are various checks we want to do on the response, and all these checks are called as assertions. Okay, now in JMeter, let us go to our test plan. So this was a test plan we created in our last session, and this is my thread group. We are doing a test on this application lifecharger.org. okay, and we had added two listeners. One is the view results in table and view results in tree. Okay, now if I have to add assertions, I go to my thread group which I have named users, do a right click, add, and assertions, and we can see there are a lot of assertions available in JMeter. In this session we are going to focus on the very commonly used and very basic assertions, and in this list response assertion is the most commonly used assertion. So I click here and I get this window for response assertion. Okay, so let me also write it down here. The first assertion is response assertion. Okay, now if you look at this window of response assertion, you have the option to apply this assertion to main sample and subsamples, main sample only, subsample only, and there is some JMeter variable. We'll talk about it later, maybe in some later sessions, but just to talk about the very basic use of this assertion. Now the second option is response field to test. Okay, so in this case I want to test the response code that the server returns. Okay, you can also test some text in the response or some document and so on. Okay, and I want to check whether the response code equals to, and I can write the code here. So I am writing 200. So I click this add button and I mentioned 200 here. So what this assertion is going to do, it will check the response. It will check the response code and compare with 200. If this matches, it will pass it, otherwise it will fail. Okay, so let me let me make it 5 users and ramp up period, let's say 1 second, and I just want one iteration. So let me start this. And you can see the results have generated here in the tree as well, and everything is in green. That means it has passed, right? And I can also cross verify it by going to the results tree, and we can see this is 200 and every response is giving 200, right? So that means my assertion has passed. Now what happens if the assertion fails? So to deliberately fail the assertion, what I'm going to do is I'm going to make it something else, let's say 201. So now it should fail because the server is giving back response code 200 and I am expecting 201. So let me run this again and let us see the results now. Now you can see everything is in red. Okay, here also everything is in red, and if I expand this, you can see this is saying response assertion failure, and it is clearly telling us that we expected 201 but we received 200. So that is why it's a failure. Okay, so this is how you can test the response assertion, and to give us a better view of the assertion results, we can add a listener called as assertion results. Okay, so if I run this again and see at the assertion results, you can see every time an assertion fails, a result is logged here, and we can see what is the failure. Comparison with 201 and received is 200, so it's a failure. So let me revert it back to 200 and see what happens now. I run it again. Now you can see in the results, assertion results, I'm not getting any exception, and I'm getting all green here, as well as in the table also everything is green. So this is what response assertion is, and this is how you can use it. Let us see the second assertion, and that will be duration assertion. Okay, so this is also a very commonly used assertion, duration assertion. So as the name indicates, duration is we are checking the duration of the response, and again we can apply it to main sample and subsamples and so on. And if I say, let me first quickly look at the duration, I'm getting a duration of around 1.5 seconds. This is in milliseconds, so you can say 1.5 second. Let me put here 1500, which will be 1.5 seconds. This is in milliseconds, right? So any response which takes more than 1500 milliseconds will be a failure, and we will get notified in the assertion results. Okay, so let me run it again and let us see if we get any response beyond 1500 milliseconds. And yes, there are, I think all the response took more than 1500 milliseconds, so that's why everything is in failure. And you can see this is the duration assertion failed. Okay, the operation lasted too long, it took 2169 milliseconds but should not have lasted longer than 1500 milliseconds, right? So let me change the duration and say this is 2200 milliseconds and run it again. Let me see this time everything passed because all the response was less than 2200 milliseconds. Okay, if I again make it 2000 millisecond and run it, let me see if anything fails. No, still everything was less than 2000 milliseconds, right? So now it is passing. So this is how we can have a duration assertion and a check on the response time. The third assertion that we are going to see here is we will see size assertion, which is also a quite commonly used assertion in JMeter. So size assertion, as the name indicates, it has to do something with the response size. Okay, now if we see our size in bytes is somewhere around 30,000 to 35 bytes. Okay, so let me say 30,000 to 35 and equals to. Okay, so if my size in bytes is equal to this particular number, then it should pass, else it should fail, and I can have multiple, you know, comparison here. Okay, So let me run it again and see if all the size assertion passes or not. And yes, I have got one failure. And you can see the result was the wrong size. It was 3228 bytes, but should have been equal to 3235 bytes, right? And if I go to my results tree, I get the same message here. Okay, the other requests also failed because of some other assertion failure, which is like the duration assertion in most of the cases. Okay, let me make the duration assertion as some higher number so that this does not fail, and run it again. Okay, so now we can see there are only three failures, and they are due to the size assertion. Okay, and the same thing is displayed here as well as in the results tree. There are three failures, and all failures are due to the size assertion. Okay, so this is how we can check the size of the response. And obviously I have made a very strict check by selecting the equals option. We mostly select either greater than or less than, or greater than equal to or less than equal to. Okay, so if I say the size should be greater than or equal to this particular number and run it again, let me see this time what happens. See, this time everything passes. Okay, this time all the assertion passed, so we are seeing all green here. Okay, so this was the size assertion. The next assertion that we are going to see is we have a HTML assertion. Okay, so the fourth assertion is HTML assertion. So what does this mean is, so we are going to check the format of our response, and it is actually going to check that the format is a valid HTML or not. Okay, in case it is not a valid HTML, it will throw out some errors and it will fail that assertion. So if I run this test now see, we have a failure for HTML assertion, and it is saying there are 38 errors and 110 warnings. Okay, now if you go back to your HTML assertions, you can actually provide a threshold for the errors as well as warning. Okay, so let me say that my threshold is 38. If there are errors more than 38, it should fail. It should give out a message, error message, and 110 are the warnings. Okay, let me run it again. Now this time it did not fail because I have failures in the HTML format, but the failures are 38 and 110 warnings, and I have made the threshold equal to that. In case I make it 37 and let me make it 109, this time it must fail. Okay, so you can see there are 38 errors and 110 warnings allowed are 37, and warnings allowed are 109. So there is a failure, and we have got the results here. The same we can see in the tree view as well. Okay, now here is the thing. This is telling us the number of errors and number of warnings, but where exactly is the error and what element is missing or what node is missing, we are not aware of that, right? So to get a report on that, what we can do is we can actually write this report to a file, and you can see this is the file name. We can browse it, and let me say I want to store all the errors here, and I can say errors only, so it will only log the errors. And now if I run this, so here are the errors. And if I go to this file, so this file is here. Now you can see it has given us all the errors, what was missing, this is not recognized, discarded expected header, and all those things. So this is a very good test to validate your HTML. And in standalone web application, this might not be a very concerning thing, but if your web application has to partner with third party apps, and they have to talk to each other, then these issues can be very big, and you will have to resolve this, right? So JMeter provides us this way to check our XML, HTML, and so on. Similarly, you can see we can do a check on XML or XHTML as well. So if I select XML and do the same run, so here everything passed. Okay, so you can do a check on XHTML as well and HTML, right? So this was HTML assertion. Let us look at some other assertions. There are XML assertions as well. So again, XML assertion is will check the format, and if it is a valid XML, then it will pass, otherwise it will fail. So we can say this is a check on the XML format, right? So see, XML assertion is failing, and it is saying the entity RAQUAO was referenced but not declared. Okay, and again, you can write this assertion to a file as well. Okay, and you can make a check on your XML, and you can actually fix this thing, right? Whatever is the assertion failure you get in your web app. One another assertion that we should look at is XPath assertion. Okay, now XPath assertion will mostly be used in API testing. So we'll be having a demo on API testing with JMeter in the coming sessions, and then we will be, you know, looking at how exactly we use the XPath assertion. For now, I'll just explain that, you know, in the response, if you want to check some particular node or some particular XPath or some value at some particular XPath, we can use XPath assertion. Okay, so XPath assertion, we will look into more details in the coming sessions, but just for, you know, a basic understanding, we want to assert some XPath or some value or some node in the response, and we can use this. Okay, so these are all the assertions, or I should say the most commonly used and the most basic assertion which we should be knowing to use JMeter assertions. One thing is that you should take care is when you add a listener for tree and you add a listener for assertion results, these listeners take up a lot of memory. Okay, so when you want to put the same test on load, maybe you can disable these listeners. But if you want to do a check on your, you know, application format and, you know, other things, you can add these listeners. Okay, otherwise you can, you know, just drop these listeners or disable them. Okay, so this was all about basic assertions in JMeter. In the coming series of this tutorial, we will look at various type of listeners in JMeter. Okay, so that's all about assertions in JMeter. Hope you like it. Thanks a lot.